Hello and welcome back to another episode of Hashtag Get Lit, where we crush your business in less than 10 minutes. Today, we are going to get started with Pinterest. I'm going to show you how you can use it to actually gain leads for your online business, whether it's online marketing, network marketing, affiliate marketing, coaching. The possibilities truly are endless, and I feel like it's the best kept secret. So stay tuned because we're going to dive right in. Okay, so for today's episode, I'm going to give you a little tour of my Pinterest page so you can see the power of Pinterest and what it can do for your business. And then future videos, we'll get into it. I also have a Pinterest program for you that you can grab. The description is below. If you want step-by-step, if you go through this and you're like, okay, there's a lot here that I didn't know about, and you need things to be slowed down and explained for you as you go, just click that link. That'll be more in-depth for you. So I'm just going to share my screen so we can pop on over to Pinterest. So if you want to check me out, I'm the Gold Digger Girl. Are you surprised? It's actually right here, Gold Digger Girl. There's no the for the username. So I want you to come follow me, say hello. So a couple cool things. You can actually create boards with other people's content to get eyeballs on your page. So it's not just about curating your own content, which you will want to do. It's about having a page where there is content that is helpful for your target audience. So for me, my number one target, I have more than one because I'm a coach. I'm a network marketing coach, but I'm also a network marketer. So I have people who I want to attract to buy my products, join my team. But my number one avatar, my number one target audience is people who I want to attract into my coaching programs. So for me, I'm going to build out my content to serve all of those purposes, but the focal point is going to be my lead target audience. So first you want to know, ask yourself, what do my people want to come to Pinterest for? So if you didn't know this, Pinterest is one of the top search engines. A lot of people come to Pinterest to find things. They come to Google to find things. They don't necessarily come to Facebook to find things. Usually it's more social. So there's a lot of, like I said, a lot of potential here on Pinterest. So for today, I just wanted to give you a quick overview. So for your background, you can actually choose, and this is on the settings, which like I said, click the link below if you need more screen share and walking you through it. But you can choose your board to show, or you can choose your background to show at one of your boards. So mine is the Girl Boss board. So it's really cool because this board right here, Girl Boss Quotes, is full of images that are aligned with my brand that aren't my quotes. And then they show up as my background, which is really cool. You also want a good profile picture that's consistent with your other social media pages. You can have a little description and you get one URL on here, or you can use something like Linktree like I do. So when it comes to boards, you just click create a board and then it's going to give you some suggestions. So for today, we are just going to look at one I just made today. So making money online. I know my audience wants to make money online, and you can see there's all kinds of other topics here that go right with my target audience wanting to learn how do they build a business on social media, because that's my expertise. So for what you're going to do for making money online is you're going to create a board. And again, this one specifically is full of other people's content. That's not a bad thing. You want your page to come up. You want your page to be searchable and you want people to find your stuff. But a secret weapon to do that is to constantly be pinning. The only way you can constantly pin new stuff, and there's an app for that, and you can schedule it out, is to have new pins. And there's, I mean, how awesome is it that you can utilize other people's pins on your page, and that will get people coming to your account and finding you and seeing your other stuff. So we're almost working in our value-driven product as the foundation, and we're working in maybe a product, and I'll give you an example of that. Maybe, you know, a blog post you wrote, a great piece of content that you put out, going to work that in, okay? And that's what I teach anyway, is I don't want you spamming and selling. I want you to add value. One of the ways to add value is to create great boards where people can find awesome stuff. And then you can create, you can build that out and you can add more to it later. You can search up here for anything and you can add things to your board. You can also just click the Pinterest and it's gonna curate content for you that it thinks you'll want to repin. So let me show you what it looks like where I have added in my products. So what would be most relatable for you is Instagram, for example. You cannot take a Facebook URL, so you can't share your Facebook content to Pinterest. However, I have a workaround using ManyChat So an example of something that you could add your content to would be this right here, Inspire on Instagram. So when you post on Instagram, you can share straight from Instagram to Pinterest. Okay, so again, all of that's explained in the workshop if you wanted to snag that. So it's awesome because if people happen to be on my page, my board, things are populating on here, they're going to see my Pinterest or my Instagram post on here. I want to show you a specific one for the product because I think this will hands down be the most relatable. So I'm in health and wellness. So this one's called Rocking Her Waistline. So on here, I have all kinds of, I have a meal recipe planner board in there, but I have all kinds of recipes, ideas, and things that people can implement. But I also put in some stuff here with my products. So that way, if people, it says down a dress size, and I tell my story real quick. I've got another one with having a spoon. So I'm not putting a bunch in here because I don't want to, you know, blow up my page, but you could put customer testimonials in here, things that will catch people's eyes. And there's the one with the spoon, and that way people can see you having success or results while enjoying some other value-based content. And then I have it going right to my website, but you could actually put them into a mini chat sequence where you could snag, capture some content, maybe their pain points, email list or email. You can do all kinds of stuff like that. And then the other thing is to be consistent in making sure you're pinning every day, because you have, at the time of this recording, I have 11. Or it just went up. It was 11,000. So it just went up to 13,000 monthly viewers. I've had it as high as 100. They did some huge algorithm changes last year. So I'm just kind of re-exploring everything to get it back on point. So I will grow it, obviously, but there, think about it. That's 13,000 views on my account. What can that do for getting new leads into my inbox? It's pretty incredible. And then you can also take YouTube stuff, podcasts, if you have those, courses, you can put that kind of content on here as well, okay? And then affiliate marketing. If you're I'm an Amazon influencer, so all of these link to my Amazon account and I get paid when people shop. And so there's just endless ways to make content or make money on Pinterest. It's unbelievable. Okay, so it's not just for pinning recipes. It's definitely for something that you can use to grow your business. So your homework is to freshen up your Pinterest account. So below say, yes, Kimberly, I am rocking my Pinterest. If you like this video, please subscribe. There's a button to subscribe and there's a bell you can hit and that'll notify you. I release new trainings every single week. And I'd love for you to try this out and get some amazing results and bring your Pinterest back to life if you haven't, but also to see how you can actually make money on Pinterest. So that's what I have for you today. I hope you found it helpful. Until next time, get lit in your business and set your soul on fire. Bye-bye. You want to say goodbye? Bye.